So tell me about growing up a Flyers fan.
Well, I was born in Buffalo, so I was a Sabres fan. And then I moved to Philadelphia in 77 and became a Flyers fan very fast. Saw Bobby Clarke play, Bill Barber, and, you know, I'm excited for them this year. A great goaltender, finally, Carter Hart, and they got some exciting young players. Joel Farabee, you know, Travis Konecny's having a great season, and they got some strong depth in their defensive positioning right now. We'll see with Philip Myers and see if Sanheim can pull it back together again.
Boston Bruins fan Donnie Wahlberg.
Boston's a hockey town. It really is. People love the Patriots. That's more of a modern times thing, but it's really a hockey town. I mean, back from the days of Bobby Orr, it's an original six team. When the Bruins get hot, it always electrifies the city.
You got to spend some time with Gretzky doing his show. What impressed you most about him?
He just is a very soft-spoken, focused individual. And when he played the game, he was just so free and his instincts were so pure. And what I also love about him, he's a big advocate for playing other sports. Like, just don't be so obsessed about playing the game of hockey. Get out there and play lacrosse, football, basketball. You know, enjoy those other sports so that you can use those mechanics.
Your brother, his workouts are legendary. How do you think he would have done as a hockey player in the NHL?
He wasn't a really good hockey player. We played street hockey as kids. We couldn't afford ice skates, so we played on, you know, on the blacktop. And he was the worst. He wouldn't have made it as a hockey player. And he likes to make people think he can fight. He would have lost his fights, too. He wouldn't even be the enforcer.
So tell me about some of these Red Wings hangouts you had.
Oh my gosh, I used to hang out with Joey Koster back in the day. I play tough guys every once in a while. No, he's a tough guy. So it's like, I'm not gonna get into fisticuffs with Joey Koster. No.
Cam Neely and I go back, and I was a fan of his for a long time. Got to know him really good, and then I've since supported his foundation. He's just a great guy. I did a TV commercial with Bobby Orr and became friends with him. There's a brotherhood in hockey. Hockey players from out of town stay.
You're in D.C. full-time now.
Yeah.
You're having a pretty good run. What part of that run is the Washington Capitals winning the Stanley Cup last year? What does a moment like that do to unite the city?
You know, it's incredible. I think many people look at Washington as a partisan town, but we've got a great sports town. First it was the Capitals, then it was the Nats, and it's really brought people together. I have two daughters. They were asking me the other day, when are we going to go to a Caps game and sit right against the glass?
We're doing our Stadium Series game this year at the Air Force
Academy.
Very cool. How cool is it to hear that the league is supporting a cause that's so important to you?
I think it's fantastic. It's great to see the NHL be involved with the veteran community and also bring into light the struggles that they have, regardless of who they are. The men and the women have fought valiantly, and they're just strong individuals.
Whatever we can do to give back, it's very easy to take for granted what the military does for us. We're able to enjoy the things we enjoy because of them, because of their sacrifice. So it's a great thing that the NHL's doing it.
You know, you look at our athletes, you look at people who are thrust into that position, and they know a little bit about discipline. They know about commitment. They know about, you know, toeing the line and being the best that you can be. So they're, I think, kindred spirits to our people, you know, in the military. And for them to step up and to help support and to you know, to give a spotlight to the military people is not surprising.
It is so important that the NHL is supporting the military and military families and veterans. This is an issue that hits close to home for me. My dad served 30 years in the Army. My sister is a surgeon in the Army. I think the more that we can support our military, the more that we can share stories of great veterans, I'm all for it.